in part of not being on top of your maintenance and being on top of just your post-ride maintenance. Now, I'm not talking oil changes and your oil filters and all that kind of stuff and making sure your prop and your wear ring and all that jazz. I'm talking basic after ride, come home, wash the ski down. And that the last one is plastic and vinyl protectants, okay? Your plastic and vinyl protectants are imperative. And I don't care. Well, I definitely care if you're leaving it out with no cover on. Please put a cover on it. I don't care if it's a cheap plastic tarp. That's better than nothing, all right? The plastics that the manufacturers today are using, especially Sea-Doo, bleach in the sun within weeks. I mean, badly, really badly. Within a month to 2 months, they're chalky. I mean, chalky white. You can scrape your finger off and pull air off, all right? The plastics they're using right now are not UV resistant. I don't care what they say. I've shown it to you, okay? And I'm imploring, please, after every ride, put some vinyl protectant on your seats and put plastic protectant, all right? Plastic protectant on all your plastics and put a cover on it. Honestly, both. Protect the plastics on your watercraft or it's going to look 10 years old after 1 year. I'm not very satisfied with the quality of plastics that Sea-Doo, Yamaha, Cowie's fine to a lesser extent. They haven't changed their formulas. And there's a lot less exposed raw black plastic. But especially with the new GP and VX Yamahas and the Sea-Doos, they're using a lot of raw textured black plastics. And guys, that stuff bleaches out really, really fast. I implore you, please, be studious about putting a layer on. I'll tell you what, I've been desperate and like Back in Black has some UV protection, but it is not a UV protectant. It is a plastic restorer. Armor All has a Back in Black type plastic restorer that is has some protection, but it's not a dedicated protectant. Everybody knows I'm a super shill for Meguiar's. I love Meguiar's. I do. I love Meguiar's. And so I talked to I talked to Mike and the agency people that I've known for years. And I've asked a lot of formula questions. And I said, listen, you know, we're encountering this in the personal watercraft industry. What do you guys think? And one of the funniest answers I got was, hey, do us a favor and put on they have what's called their ultimate tire shine. And it's this grape glue. It's grape scented purple goo. And I took an applicator pad like I would use for my tires. And I put it on the Bonrail and the bumpers. And they said, just tell us how well it holds out. And the problem is that it's so sticky that it contacts you and you're like, okay, this is getting on my stuff. But the shine lasted for a month. Like, it was unreal. Do I recommend using it? No. They actually have some tire shine, which is a really good penetrating protectant. And I've used that on microfiber towels, and I've used that on a lot of the black plastics. And that has been why, quite frankly, the RX PX looks the way it does. Is I've been using Meguiar's tire foam on a rag and applying that. And a lot of those plastics are really good.
Hey, guys. Thanks for hanging out. This clip was taken from our weekly podcast that we record here every Sunday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. If you want to watch the whole video, you can go to the Watercraft Journal's YouTube channel, go to playlists, and then click on live sessions. You're going to see it there. Otherwise, go ahead and leave a like, a comment, and definitely subscribe to the channel. It helps us grow. And again, thanks again for watching our videos, and we hope to see you soon.